My name is Lynn Lichwana Carlton from the Swedish University of Agricultural Sciences in Sweden. We have been here at CIFOR for the past 3 days having a workshop on conducting a systematic review on gender, forest and food security. We have partnered together with various partners and colleagues from the International Institute of Environment and Development, from the Stockholm Environmental Institute, from the Lilongwe University of Agriculture and Natural Resources, as well as civil society, farmer organization, activists. We have spent the past 3 days trying to formulate the research question, which is looking at gender disparities in understanding the access as well as the use of forest assets in attaining household food security. The systematic review will enable us to evaluate the available evidence and to draw conclusions from what we find in the analysis of the available evidence as to what some of the gaps or what some of the issues that still need addressing are. It brings together the potential of combining the various partners that is conducting these systematic reviews in order to establish a basis for having evidence to inform policy. And the role of SLU here becomes even stronger as we connect with CIFOR, that is one of our major partners whom we have signed a memorandum of understanding with. It advances our capabilities and our capacities on how to conduct systematic reviews. At the same time, it brings us closer to working with various partners around the globe in understanding these wider issues of gender, forests, and food security.
Well, as the coordinator of the research group Gender and Forestry, I find it extremely important that this systematic review is carried out. You see, UFRO is a network of researchers and research organizations, but it has no resources itself to carry out this kind of work. So the activities within UFRO very much depends on activities and initiatives taken by member organizations and researchers. And this is a really great initiative. It can, and I see that there are basically two ways, or maybe say maybe three ways of doing it. One is at the sessions, the technical sessions, but also more generally by organizing, for example, a gender cafe that can take place all days throughout the conference. And maybe this will be the most important forum for dissemination, because still gender issues is by many perceived as a women's issue or something that has a very particular interest. It's not regarded as kind of a cross topic, cross sectoral, cross business or issue that covers most of the disciplines within forestry. It does not go only with human resources, it has an impact on silviculture, it has an impact on forest technology and so on.
Thank you much. My name is Isilda Nyantumbu. I work for the International Institute for Environment and Development. I work mainly on trade-related issues, including gender and how it is reflected in the policies as well as in the implementation of RED on the ground. And we are undertaking case studies in 6 countries, Mozambique, Tanzania, Nepal, Vietnam, Peru, and Guatemala, in order for us to understand how gender mainstreaming in the RED strategy is being undertaken, and also to understand the link between the drivers of forest deforestation and forest degradation with commodities, and by using value chain analysis to understand who plays what role and who benefits or is likely to be a loser in that process. And we are working together with the University of Agriculture Science in Sweden, which is also responsible for the systematic review, which will look at much broader set of literature from all the 3 continents I just mentioned a few examples for. So I think we will be able to draw on that wealth of knowledge that the review will bring and inform the studies that we are conducting. But also we hope that the results of case studies will produce some materials and some recommendations that can be taken on board in the systematic review. And we have planned, for example, a conference to look at gender linked with many aspects, gender in the context of urbanization and food security, gender and land issues, as well as the link between gender and climate change. And I also think that is a platform which any results or preliminary results produced from this could be shared. We also produce policy briefs. We hope that we can bring some of the results from this scientific-based study to a more policy-oriented audience. At IID, we have what we call the DFID Accountable Grant, which is supporting the Institute to conduct research in many areas. And through that, we are aiming to continue working on gender-related issues. Therefore, the identification of gaps can inform what research issues we can look into in detail. Particularly in the case studies that we would like to bring, because we think there is a value in looking at the policies and the processes related to RED in particular in the countries, but also related more broadly with the utilization of natural resources, water, land, forests in general. So I would like us to work synergetically together with CIFOR to bring the resources that we have, be it our expertise, but also putting together financial resources to facilitate further research on those issues.
I'm Caroline Ochieng. I'm a research fellow at Stockholm Environment Institute working on energy. So there are 3 things that come to mind in terms of why the link has not been explored. And one is that when you talk of the household energy access in developing countries, it's a very gendered issue, mainly affecting women, and not just women, but those in remote settings in rural developing countries. So the concerns and the issues and how energy affects food does not easily make it to public limelight. And then secondly, there's the tendency of us researchers liking to focus on one discipline. So I'm an energy person or a gender person or a food security person. So we work separately, we don't link together. in a way that enables us to explore the issues jointly, which is something that this systematic review is addressing, and in a very unique way, because you are looking at three different topics, that's gender, forests and food security, bringing in people from different disciplines and expertise in the issue, and that ensures that at the end of the review, the recommendations that come out consider all the three issues together and come up with concrete ways of addressing it. Normally, again, there's a focus to do research and forgetting the communication component of it. So then an output of research being a journal publication, for instance, how many policymakers get access to those journals, or how many people in developing countries? So I think we would need to find innovative ways of communicating with policymakers and practitioners around these issues. So if it's policy briefs, for instance, that's something that ACI is very keen on in terms of linking research to policy and practice, and maybe awareness sessions with the policymakers to. And this should not just come at the end of the research, but it should be an ongoing engagement so that whatever review we are doing is actually addressing the needs of the stakeholders, then they would be more receptive of the findings. So I think with this review, it's sort of setting up a model that others should replicate, starting with the needs assessment, then delving into the research, and then going back to the stakeholders and letting them know of the output.
My name is David Nkwambisi, the programs coordinator from Rirongo University of Agriculture and Natural Resources. And I'm also a senior lecturer in environment and development. To help us to revise the research agenda that we have for the university, but also the process has given us the capacity to help the faculties to review the curriculum so that we can incorporate issues that have been discussed here. We are also hoping that we might have new programs depending on the systematic review that we have here. In addition, I think this process will help the university to start producing policy briefs that can be used by several stakeholders, not only in Malawi, but also maybe in the region. Yeah, thanks. Looking at the work that CIFOR is doing, we seriously think that they can contribute to the research component, whereby the experts from CIFOR can come to Malawi, work with local researchers on different sectors, especially the forest sector. In particular, we are very much interested in modeling, but also understanding the greenhouse emissions from the forest sector, but also maybe the soil carbon fluxes. Apart from that, they can also help us in the teaching. We have short courses both at national level, but also at regional level, especially those that will be covering at SADC and COMESA level. So because they've got experts in modeling, we need such type of support from CIFOR. Then we have also started new programs, postgraduate programs like PhD by research. Either our students can come to CIFOR to be close to the experts, or CIFOR experts can come to Malawi to support the research and the PhD programs. We are also thinking of our students to be attached to CIFOR, but also maybe CIFOR has got junior researchers or fellow researchers who can come to Malawi and participate in several research and training programs.
My name is Ngoli Akimanzu. Yeah, I have worked with farmers organizations, farmer movements, smallholder farmers organizations in the area of forestry, agroforestry development to strengthen their positions in the market value chains. And I think such a workshop like we've had today is very important in that it looks at the aspect of gender and the food security outcomes in the whole chain of forest management. Women, for very many years, have really been disempowered in forest management, in tree establishment, in the harvesting, even in the access of natural forests. So a review like this one will help us to understand the role of different gender in managing the resource. And we know, for instance, there have been a number of studies, a number of development programs, both from the civil society and from the research organizations that have been looking at the question of gender, women participation in natural resource management. And such a review, it has such a depth and reach that we will be able to understand, look at the policy recommendations, the existing policies, what new policies are needed to strengthen the position of women, and also institutions, the interventions that can help to strengthen the position of women in development of forestry and also agroforestry programs that form part of this natural resource management system. For us in the civil society, who are actually part of this review, we look at upon this as a very important exercise, all the information that will be collected, and we will disseminate it through our various channels. You know, we are part of the global farmers' movements. There are several meetings that they hold every year. Those are very important channels. We also have like communication strategies in the different civil society movements. So we look at every opportunity to make sure that the results of this work are disseminated. We also know, for instance, many development organizations at the UN level, they recognize the importance of farmers' organizations. Just to quote an example, the International Fund for Agricultural Development, they have an annual farmers' conference in Rome around February of every year. So we will look at that an important venue to disseminate this important. And I know also that there have been several, movements and initiatives on the question of gender, even at the World Bank level. And they also call meetings for civil society. So we'll use all those different channels to disseminate these findings. And at the same time, work with both CIFOR and the Swedish University of Agricultural Sciences to develop small pamphlets and small documentaries that we can use and disseminate to our membership, to our global membership network.
I want to say a big thank you for Peter. I wouldn't be doing this interview if it wasn't for him. And I would also want to say thank you to Lindley and Jessica, basically the whole big part of this. And we wouldn't be doing anything about forest assets and access. I wouldn't be saying anything about that right now if it weren't for them. And thank you to Lucilia, because I wouldn't even be in Indonesia right now. So. CIFOR is a really nice place. It's quite warm and it's homely, and they've got a nice swimming pool. So the people at CIFOR are very kind, and they know everything about the place, and I just want to work here sometimes because the people are that kind. Well, I learned that everything's quite serious, and gender is basically women's rights and wrongs and men's rights and wrongs. And forest access and assets means that different types of forests in different places, and the access just means that you can access to forests. Food security is when people eat anything like berries, bananas, and Well, I took this morning session of exercises and it really got them going instead of just sitting there for the whole day. So I call them EE, energizing exercises, and it's really fun to teach them.
Do you think they were fit, these scientists, or were they a bit lazy?
They were fit.